One of the most mind-bending discoveries we've ever made in space is black holes. A black hole is a place in space where gravity pulls in so much that not even light can escape. The gravity is so strong because the matter's been squeezed into a tiny space. Black holes can be caused when a star dies. Because no light can escape, this means they're totally invisible and black. And of course, they suck in anything that goes anywhere near them. So that begs the question, what would happen if two of these black holes collided? This actually can and does happen. But what happens when it does, and what if it happened near to Earth? I'm Charlie, and today we're going to look at what if two black holes collided. But before we get into it, subscribe, and why not press the notification bell too. Black holes can be big or small, but one of the most amazing kinds of black holes are supermassive black holes. These have masses which range from millions or billions of suns. They sit at the center of the most massive galaxies across our universe. And there are even some in our galaxy, the Milky Way. What's interesting is right now, we don't know how supermassive black holes come to be. We understand black holes, but we don't know how supermassive black holes get so big. One theory is it could happen from a supernova. A supernova is when a star explodes, blasting part of that star into space. But let's say something very unlikely happens and two black holes merge together. This can sometimes happen during a merger of galaxies. This is something we do see in our universe. But thankfully, our galaxy, the Milky Way, has not merged with another galaxy before. If two black holes collided, they would release gravitational waves. These would be fluctuations in the fabric of space-time. Right now, we can use simulations to predict these merges. Scientists have seen that these emit both gravitational waves and radiation. That's because when the two black holes collide, interstellar gas rises from them. This creates very hot, radioactive waves. When the black holes fall towards one another, they merge into one. This cosmic clash would be very bad for any surrounding planets. If it happened too near to Earth, then radiation could take out some of the human population. It would be like Chernobyl, but in space, and about 10 million times worse. Right now, we actually don't have the facilities to observe supermassive black holes merging together. Scientists have simply used simulations to see what would happen, but we do have the technology to witness two normal black holes merging together. They can actually see what's happening inside these black holes. The human eye can't see a black hole because strong gravity pulls in all of the light. But scientists can measure how strong gravity affects the stars and gas around the black hole. They study the stars flying around or orbiting the black hole and then work out what would happen from them. They study the stars flying around or orbiting the black holes. And then, using that data, they work out what's happening. One theory is that if two big black holes merge together, this could make a supermassive black hole. These are black holes which are about 10 times the size of a normal black hole. The reason why this may happen is because you're adding gravity into more gravity. It's kind of like the video game Agar.io. If two worms collide, they merge into one even more powerful worm. And that's kind of a great metaphor for black holes, as they go around galaxies, zapping up anything near them. But on that note, what happens to the matter which is dragged into a black hole? Where does it go and what happens to it? Well, to understand this, you need to know what the event horizon is. The event horizon is the space where light can escape from the black hole's gravitational field and the space where it can't. So, basically, where the matter does and doesn't exist simultaneously. The matter in the event horizon becomes isolated from the rest of time and space. It effectively disappears from the universe that we exist in. Once inside the black hole, the matter will be torn apart into subatomic components. It then becomes stretched and squeezed until it becomes a part of the black hole and increases its size. And that's how black holes increase in size, again, kind of like the game Agar.io. So hopefully now you understand a bit more about this mind-bending science humans know little about. It's kind of crazy to think black holes break the space-time continuum, but they do. But now it's time to make your voice heard. Vote in the poll in the top right corner. If you had the chance to visit space, would you go? If you want some more awesome videos, then check out my second channel. But as always, thank you for watching. There's some more videos you may like on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.